Destination Millions. We're having a good time tonight, guys. Yeah. And we're having a good time because we're showing people how to make. Yeah. Okay, now what if I told you at home, you got your product, ready to go, and overnight, I can get it in front of tens of millions of people. Overnight, you'd say, when do I sign on? Well, that's getting on HSN. You can get in those holy gates immediately overnight, sell them to tens of millions of people. How do you do that? Sandy Conrad, Senior Vice President of Merchandising for HSN. How do you do that? How do I get on? Okay, give me the tips. I know I got this. People call to, I gotta get on. How do I get on?
Is it just me, or do you smell money in here?
I smell
lots of money in here.
I love it.
Okay. There are great products every day. Not every product is made for TV, but a lot of them are. And I think the first thing that you have to do as entrepreneurs is really understand your product. And by that I mean be able to articulate what it is that makes your product different. And you have to do it very succinctly.
So people, you guys have open calls, basically. You see new people?
Sure, we do. We get a lot of submissions. We see, every year we see tens of thousands of submissions.
So basically, number one, you better be able to call it down to a point of difference.
That's right.
You can't just come in and say, I got a new cosmetic. We're going to get affiliate cosmetic.
Right.
You better. So once again, I think this is great for any practice, not just getting on HSN. Boil it down. You can't pitch it in a simple, compelling one thought. Don't have it. So that's number
Absolutely.
One. Get it simple. Know your product. Get on it.
Number two, identify your target audience. We're in 89 million households. For us to be successful, for you to be successful, we need to cast the broadest net. So a niche product is not going to work so well for us on TV. A broader one does.
So basically, their business model is 90 million, and it's selling to half, a third of the country. You better have something that's going to have a huge wide appeal. If you're going on the air with, you know, an $8,000 blazer, probably not going to make sense.
Correct.
Okay.
But what I've learned today, underwear. Right? That's everybody.
We love underwear on the Big Idea. It sells, people like talking about it, it's fun. Okay, how do I know about the price-value relationship?
Well, I think you can use yourself as a guide, right? Nobody likes to feel taken advantage of. Everybody likes to feel that they got a good deal. So the price that you present the product to us, we're obviously going to have to assign a retail price to it and sell to the market. So if I sold it to you, would you feel that you got a good value?
That's what we talked about earlier. You sometimes ask your friends, what would you pay for this?
Right.
The consumer's not stupid out there.
Absolutely,
you know,
not.
It was a great lesson I was learning in the advertising business. There's no masses. There's no they. It's your next door neighbor. It's your wife. It's your friend. It's you. So don't imagine. Just say, what makes sense? What's fair? I think that's great advice.
And I think the really important thing is you can't cut corners on that.
Yeah.
I mean, it has to be a good quality product for the price.
Okay. You also say that you got to have a great demo.
Right.
What is that? Tell me about that.
Well, think through what are the before and afters going to be. You know, do you take the buyer into the ladies' room and show her your white pants?
Okay. And finally, you talk about something we talk about in the show all the time, persistence.
Yeah, absolutely. You have to be persistent. You need to listen to the feedback that you hear. If you continue to hear no, 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 maybe you have to spin it a different way. Maybe some things have changed in the marketplace, but you need to be persistent.
Okay, I'm at home right now, and I want to get in front of you, or you're not the person who's doing it. What's the best way tactically? Okay, I'm getting there. I'm getting in front of HSN. What do you do?
Go to our website.
Okay.
HSN.com, and in the search box, type in Become a Vendor.
If you want to save some people some time at home, what does it, beyond the fact that something is not broad enough, any other categories that are just not right for HSN? You know, for instance?
I have to say no.
Okay.
You know, I think the only thing that is a bit cost prohibitive, items that are really heavy and difficult to ship. I mean, you have to remember, folks watch us on TV or go to our website and we have to ship it to you.
Okay, so once again, you're home.